The agricultural sector remains in recession, and of course that has a huge impact on these GDP figures. Let's chat to Wandile Sihlobo. He's from AgBiz. He joins us live from our studio in Pretoria. Wandile, 0.2% is pretty bleak, but if you look at agriculture, you're at minus 0.3% quarter on quarter. Can you put that in context, kind of before and since the drought began? Where does that figure sit?
No, I mean, certainly the agricultural sector is not in good shape. And we've been pretty much contracting for about the past 7 quarters right now. And now what we see really weighing on in there is what's going on in the grains and the oilseed sector. Because even though there has been drought, some of the other sectors like the wine industry, the fruit industry, to some extent, they've seen some little bit of momentum on export activity and a little bit of production in there. But when you look directly on what's been happening in the grains and the oilseed sector, and that's where we see that contraction pretty much stemming from. Production in there has pretty much contracted by about 23% on a year-on-year basis, with all our grains and oilseeds that we're producing only coming up and making about roughly 9 million tons. And that was a further contraction from what we saw last year. And in a normal year, you would imagine South Africa would have roughly about 16 million tons. So it's not looking well, and the key driver of that is pretty much the drought.
And this weighs on overall GDP. How big is the agricultural sector in South Africa?
No, I mean, the agricultural sector, when you're looking on a GDP perspective, it is not as big as other sectors, roughly about 2.4%. But of course, there are interlinkages that pass through to the manufacturing sector, which makes up roughly 13% of the GDP. So that's where the effects you are actually seeing. And I mean, you might remember even earlier in the year when we started to see the intensity of the drought, many international institutions like the IMF started to revise down South Africa's growth. And part of that was also the drought. They did attribute it to that. So the spillover effects on that, not only just in production, but also going on to the labor market, going on to the manufacturing, that's what's really concerning. And also, if you look at some of the sectors that feed through to the agricultural sector, your machinery sector, your guys who are providing seeds, your guys who are providing on some of the other inputs like fertilizers and stuff, that's where actually some of the things that are concerning gets to come about.
Wandile, this is simplistic, but what do the recent rains mean? I mean, we're in a drought and everybody's trying to predict, when will it come to an end? How do you look at those weather patterns when you make predictions, for example?
No, I mean, I think now we have actually bottomed out. And I mean, when you're looking on now in the fourth quarter and also going on to the next year, we're pretty much optimistic. And you see that in both in statistics and in sentiment. Measuring sentiment through the Agribusiness Confidence Index, it shows that in the past 2 quarters of this year, it has pretty much edged up above 50 being our standard point. And it means that the agribusinesses, the banks are pretty much optimistic. They are lending money to the farmers. The activity is ongoing on that side. And also when you look on the climatic conditions, you know, the weather pattern forecast is showing on some bit of a more optimistic future. And on the ground, we are seeing the farmers in the eastern side of South Africa, they have finished planting. So far, everything is looking well in there. What we're concerned about is what's going on in the western side of South Africa. That's where a large part of our white maize is being produced. But as we speak at this point, I would say that the next couple of months will pretty much be better than what we're currently seeing.
Okay, so some better signs, some signs of a tentative recovery. What are you expecting in the fourth quarter then?
No, I mean, in the fourth quarter, we expect that we will land on in a positive territory. You might see roughly 0.2 or so. But as you go on in the next year, you should pretty much start now to see some decent numbers, maybe around about 2%, 3% or so. But certainly the fourth quarter is not going to be that much a big number. But there is activity as compared to third quarter. So definitely we might land in positive territory.
What does this mean for food prices? Let's move to something else. Because there were predictions going into Christmas, poultry affected because of the grains, things like that. What are you seeing in the trickle down to food prices?
No, I mean, certainly when you're looking on in the food prices, for example, just food inflation, the headline number right now is sitting on at around about 12% on a year-on-year basis. And as we go on to the next year, to this year on a December figure, we expect that figure to pretty much maybe go up again by roughly around about 12.3% on a year-on-year basis. The consumers will only start to get some relief around mid-2017. The first quarter is not really going to give us that much relief, because whatever goes on in the field, even if we do get the rainfalls that we expect, output will really start to come towards the second quarter. So consumers will pretty much have a bit of a hard time right now as we go on in the first quarter of next year. And one of the other things, just quickly, that I might mention is what's going on within the meat market, because you see, when you're looking on in the food inflation, one of the biggest components that drives up that number is what goes on in the meat market. And right now, 2015, we're seeing a high number of slaughtering of cattle in there. And right now, as climatic conditions improve and droughts improve, farmers might slaughter less, and that is going to drive up prices. And that's what you're going to be seeing underlying the food inflation.
Yes, because ironically, so meat has come down because of that slaughtering rate. When will it start to change then?
In the second quarter or first quarter, as well as the second quarter of next year, you should start to see the meat prices pretty much going up. In fact, if you look at it now, it's roughly about 5% on a year-on-year basis up. And then as you go in the first quarter of next year, you could see that number rising, going to level of around about 10%. But I suspect that once you get to levels of around about 15% on a year-on-year basis, you'll start to see some consumer resistance in there. But generally, if you reach a double-digit figure, that should start to put on some intense pressure on a general food inflation, which is why as we go on into next year, we suspect that food inflation will pretty much decelerate, but it might be at levels around about 9%, 7%. You won't see it going on into deflation, even if we were to get some good supplies on the grains. But because of those dynamics that are happening in the meat market, they pretty much keep the food inflation pretty much at a higher level.
Wandile, final question for you. You're talking about a bottoming out, some tentative signs of relief for consumers, for the agricultural sector. But what is the state of the sector? How many farmers have we lost, say? Or has the sector been able to limp along and can now benefit from the better times ahead?
No, I mean, what has been happening with the 2015-16 drought, it pretty much weighed on heavily on the cash flows. But as per to say how the farmers have been actually been doing, surely within the guys, for example, the smallholder farmers in the rural areas, those guys, it's pretty much a difficult situation for them, particularly the livestock. And on the commercial farmer side, there is a component of the guys that will pretty much feel the hard time. And it's estimated that roughly about 1 billion rands will not be able to be paid back to the banks. But looking on overall to say how the sector is actually doing, we use an indicator, for example, the intentions to plant data, which came up. A number of farmers in there indicated that they will be able to plant roughly around about 2.4 million hectares of land in South Africa. That is pretty much good for maize, because the normal level is roughly around about 2.6 million hectares. But overall, all of the crops in South Africa, to say what's going happening, we see a little bit of a jump in the area plantings, about 15%, coming on slightly below the normal rate. So that suggests that even though some of the farmers fell off, but generally we are getting on into pretty much on a good shape.
All right, that is good news now that we're facing the end of the drought. Hopefully, thank you. Always great to speak to you, Wandile Sihlobo, economist from AgBiz. All right, let's move on to the markets. The JSE is...